I've been practicing Christianity poorly for over 20 years, and you know, I think that I love going into the bars and talking about Jesus, where you don't get a lot of folks in bars don't normally talk about Jesus. I also love going to talk to church folks and talking about doubt and how nobody really knows anything. I love to just shake people up, man, make them think about things, especially when it comes to the spirituality. And, you know, no matter how steeped in your tradition or no matter how strong the tie to your spiritual connection may be, we all have to face the reality that faith isn't knowledge. Faith isn't the same as knowing. It's a lot of hope, and it's a lot of taking a couple steps forward, only being able to see the light that's right in front of your feet. And I think about death a lot because I write songs for a living, and about what happens after. I have a set of ideas about what that is, and I hope I'm right, but I also don't know. But when I get to thinking about that, especially when I get real scared about being wrong, I think about this story that my dad told me. And my parents are really pragmatic people, but this story is... my grandfather died before I was born. His name was Harold, and my dad told me this story that he had dropped out of college to move home with his dad to nurse him, basically over to the other side. His body had wasted away, he couldn't lift his head up off the pillow. Basically, he could just move his eyes, and that was there with him in the bed the day that he died. And for weeks, they'd been feeding him in a tube. He hadn't been able to do anything except blink. But in his last moment, he sat bolt upright in his bed with his spine ramrod straight, and he lifted his hands, both of them, high up into the air. And looking past my dad into the middle distance, said, "Can you see it? It's so beautiful." And that's what this song is about. Trying to be okay with not knowing.
Sometimes it is. Thank you so much, Bill.